In this video, I'm excited to announce that I'll be working on a brand new project, an MMORPG where you can do whatever you
want. Whoa, what the heck? Who are you?
I'm you.
You're me?
Yeah, you from the future.
Well, that must mean you have some sort of important message for me, right?
Yeah. I actually do have a message, and it's about that project. It's a total flop.
I knew I shouldn't have done an MMO. Everyone on Discord told me not to, especially a piece of fruit.
No, it's not that. MMOs are easy. Anyone can make one. The problem's with the code. It's just too coupled. Every time I fix one bug, 10 more sprout up in its place. And there's no way to guard against future regressions.
Oh, no, that sounds awful. Well, what do we do to fix it?
To be honest, I've been doing my research and I think the answer is unit tests.
Unit tests? Ah, man, I don't even know how to set up a project for unit tests. The documentation online is pretty bad.
Don't worry, man. I've been doing a ton of reading. I gotcha.
All you have to do to get started is to right-click anywhere in your assets folder. I'm just going to right-click on the root, expand the Create menu, and then expand the Testing menu and click on Test Assembly Folder. This will create a folder in your project that's set up for testing. But what does that mean, set up for testing? Well, if we take a look at what's in this folder, we can see that there's a test assembly. The test assembly is set up for, well, testing. The key here is this constraint, Unity include tests,
as well as these assembly definition references to UnityEngine.testRunner and UnityEditor.testRunner.
So at this point, we can navigate back to our test folder, right-click, select Create, expand the testing folder, and click on C# test script. This is just one way to create tests, and we're actually not finished. To show you what I mean, let's open up the test runner, which will give us a little more information. First, expand the Window menu, then General, and click on Test Runner. Here we can see a simple window that has two tabs at the top. We're currently in the Edit Mode tab, which doesn't have much for now, so let's navigate to the Play Mode tab. And there they are, the tests that we just created. So, wait, how do we create edit mode tests? There was only one option for tests in that create menu, right? And what's the difference between play mode and edit mode tests anyway? I think I'm going to leave that for another video. But for now, let me show you how to create edit mode tests as well. There's actually two ways to do it. One is by convention, and the other is by configuration. First, though, I'm going to just dock this test runner to the left of my project folder. Great. So in Unity, by convention, any script file that's nested anywhere inside of an editor folder will be placed into its own DLL called editor, which means if I create a folder called editor and place a C# script in there, then it'll automatically be added to our edit mode tests, as we can see here in the test runner. And we can see this assembly-c-sharp-editor.dll that this script has been associated with. Now, this is great and all, but honestly, I've been burned time and time again by frameworks that rely heavily on convention. To me, it's just too error-prone, and it requires too much upfront knowledge about how the framework works. So instead of doing it this way, I'm going to just delete this editor folder that I created. What we can do is navigate up to the root folder and click on Create Edit Mode Test Assembly Folder that now appears inside of the Edit Mode tab of the test runner. And we can see we have another test folder that defaults to Test 1. We'll rename that in a second, but let's open it up and examine the assembly file that was created. We can see that it has the Unity include tests constraint, but what's also important to note is that under platforms, only the editor platform is checked, whereas with the other test assembly, any platform was selected. And believe it or not, that is the only difference between setting up edit mode and play mode tests. Now, writing them and using them is a whole nother story, but again, we're going to save that one for another video. To finish up this video, I think we're going to rearrange this because I personally don't like having folders called Tests 1. Let's make this a little more clear. First, I'm going to rename the editor test assembly to edit mode tests and click apply. And I'm going to rename the file as well to match. Lastly, I'm going to be nesting these two test folders into a parent folder called tests. So I'm just going to call the folder edit mode. And now we can do the same thing for our play mode tests. First, I'm going to call the folder play mode. Oops. Rename the assembly as well. We'll call this play mode tests. And then update the actual assembly name as well. Lastly, I'm going to create in our assets folder here a folder called tests. And then just drag the play mode and edit mode folders into that. And that's it. Now we have this folder for edit mode tests, but I haven't actually created any. So I'm going to go ahead and right click, create testing, and then select C# test script. And now if we look over into the edit mode tab in the test runner, we can see we have a test from our new test script. Perfect.
Now we're almost ready to write our first tests, but before we do that, we're going to have to make sure that our tests have access to the classes that we've written for our game. In order to do that, we'll have to add an assembly to our scripts folder. So we'll go ahead and navigate there, right click, expand the create menu, and click on assembly definition. And then we'll go ahead and just rename this main, both the file and of course the name of the assembly as well. Click apply. Now we'll have to take this assembly and reference it in our edit mode test assembly. We can do that by clicking on edit mode tests, and then underneath the assembly definition references section, we can click the plus sign, select the empty reference, and then locate and click on the main assembly. Now, once we press apply, every class that's associated with that main assembly, which are the ones located in the scripts folder, will be available to the edit mode tests. So at this point, we can go ahead and switch to the code editor. Now, the class we're going to be testing, this basic counter class, is very simple, and it just serves as a really dumb example that is easy to follow. What we're going to be testing is this increment method. We're going to make sure that the count gets incremented when it's called. And we're also going to test this small bit of business logic where the count can never exceed the max count. All right, so let's go ahead and open up our test script. We can see that it's already populated with a bunch of boilerplate code. We can go ahead and just remove that. And then let's make a new test using a live template. Shout out to my previous video. We can call this test increment. And again, this is a very simple example. I would not structure my tests like this or name them like this. We're going to follow the assign, act, and assert paradigm here. First, we'll assign a variable, our system under test, which is the counter. I like to be explicit, so I'm just going to pass in 0 for the count, even though it's defaulted to 0. In tests, I try to be as explicit as possible, so anyone trying to debug a regression won't have to dig too far to understand the state of the class or systems under test. Next, we're going to act on this by calling increment. And lastly, we're going to just assert our expectation, which is that the current count is equal to 1. All right, so in Rider, we can very easily run this by selecting this little symbol here and clicking Run All. And we can see that our test passed. All right, let's do one more just for fun, because I find unit testing fun. Yes, I am a psychopath. We're going to call this one Test Max Count. All right, same thing as before. We'll go ahead and assign a variable, our system under test. This time, we're going to give it a count of 10, since that's what we expect our max count to be. Again, I like to be explicit and use cold, hard numbers. We'll call increment. That's our act phase. And then lastly, we're going to assert that the count is still equal to 10, because it should not have gone past the max. Okay, we can navigate down to the unit test explorer. We see that our new test shows up. Go ahead and press play. And it passes with flying colors. So that should be all you need to get started. Listen, I got to get out of here. I'm not really sure how this time travel thing works, and I think I've probably already overstayed my welcome.
Wait, no way, man. I need better examples.
Sure, I've got my test set up, but...
Don't worry, man. Don't worry. We'll cover that in another video. I promise.
Are you sure? I mean, have you seen that in the future? Hey, come on.
Huh. I guess he had to go. Maybe in the future, my MMO is a smashing success. Ooh, and maybe I finally surpassed 20,000 subscribers. Sure hope so. In the meantime, I should probably learn how to do some unit tests. If that's something you'd like to see, then let me know in a comment. And leave a like on this video if you enjoyed it. It really helps out. Well, I better get back to work. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Time travel.
Special thanks to Dark Rush Photography, NZ, Thomas, Trond, and Wayne Glows.